Hi, Jim Shaw here from Crystal Group, spending just a moment talking a little bit about MIL-STD 810 and diving in a little bit deeper about some of the test procedures and processes and methods that are available within MIL-STD 810. And 810 is really a compilation of 24 different tests that are available for either an integrator to specify or an engineer to design to or test to. And those procedures are, they really start out MIL-STD 810, then there's usually a rev letter, and then anywhere from 500 to 523. So there's 24 different test methods. Those tests include low pressure, high temperature, low temperature, temperature shock, contamination by fluids, solar radiation or sunshine, rain, humidity, fungus, salt fog, sand and dust, explosive atmosphere, immersion, acceleration, vibration, acoustic noise, shock, pyroshock, acidic atmosphere, gunfire vibration, temperature, humidity, vibration, and altitude, icing, freezing rain, ballistic shock, and vibroacoustic temperature. So those are the 24 different tests that are available under MIL-STD 810, and each one of those tests has a variety of potentially procedures and processes that need to be specified by the customer. So let's just look at one example of MIL-STD 810. Let's pick method 501, which is really high temperature operation. So that test method is broken up into procedures one and procedure two. The first one is storage and the second one is operation. What are you looking for when you are doing this kind of testing? You're looking for circuit board stability. Is the electronics actually operating in a stable manner? You're looking in our industry, is the CPU throttling or starting to inject wait states into the process? Are the chipsets for the circuit board working correctly? Are the magnetics and the power supply starting to suffer some loss of capability because of hysteresis? So you're looking for deterioration of bonded surfaces, anything that would impact the short term or potentially long term of the product. So for us, we're obviously looking at, we want to be substantially below the maximum limit for the temperatures so that we can ensure that the product has a long life. Ultimately, it's not just about the immediate performance, whether or not the CPU is working, but will the product last a long time in that environment? And so we're obviously looking at how to get those components cool and keep them cool in the operation of the unit over its lifetime. And so method 501 is just one of those 24 test methods that are available in MIL-STD 810, and it just happens to be high temperature operation and storage. Again, you can dive down into procedure one, procedure two, and all of the variables that are associated with that particular application. We find it's best to just set a limit and then make that limit fairly extreme, and then perform all of our products to those limits. So an example, plus 55 to minus 40 is what we shoot for all of our products, so that we don't have to continually change the test process. But again, that's just one of those test methods that we're talking about today. And there's 23 other ones that you can look at. Have a great day. Join us next time for another shiny object at Crystal Group.